Good morning, children. So, hope you all have gone through the video which I have uploaded last week. Today, I am going to continue the chapter. So, we have stopped at page number 18. I am going to start from there, the explanation part of the chapter, The Cherry Tree. Winter came early. The cherry tree bent low with the weight of snow. We all know where the author lives. In winter, there is snowfall. So, there was snowfall and the leaves all were bending because of the snow falling over the leaves and the branches of the cherry tree. Field mice sought shelter into the roof of the cottage. The road from valley was blocked. We all know in hilly areas when there is heavy snowfall, the roads are blocked and the traffic is hindered. They are not, the people are not allowed to move up or come down from that place. For several days there was no newspaper and this made grandfather quite grumpy. Initially we have read that grandfather was very fond of reading newspaper. Since he could not read, he used to make Rakesh read newspaper for him. Since the roads were blocked due to the heavy snowfall, grandfather was very grumpy. Now the word grumpy means bad tempered and irritated because he was not able to know what is happening in the other part of the world. His stories began to have unhappy endings. In February, it was Rakesh's birthday. He was 9 and the tree was 4. But almost as tall as Rakesh. Now the cherry tree was almost as tall as Rakesh. Though cherry tree was only 4 years old, Rakesh was 9 years old. One morning when the sun came out, grandfather came into the garden. "Let some warmth get into my bone." In winters we also see when we usually don't have good sunlight, but the day we get good sunlight, we see our elderly people, even we also go out and sit on our terrace and in the veranda to enjoy the sunlight. The same way grandfather also came out to the garden to enjoy some sunlight. He said he stopped in front of the cherry tree, stared at it for a few moments and then called out, "Rakesh, come and look. Come quickly before it falls." So he went out, he stared at the cherry tree and he found something unusual and he wanted to share that with Rakesh. So he called Rakesh and said, "Hurry up, come out quickly, otherwise it may fall." Rakesh and grandfather gazed at the trees as though it had performed a miracle. There was a pale pink blossom at the end of a branch. Now what does the word gazed mean? Gazed mean to look steadily with admiration or surprise. So for what they were surprised? Because they have seen a pale pink blossom. It can be a flower, a small blossom, a cherry was growing, a small cherry. The following year there were more blossoms. The coming years, there were more blossoms, more cherry had grown. And suddenly the tree was taller than Rakesh, even though it was less than half his age. Now the cherry tree was growing very fast and now it was taller than Rakesh. Children, here I am comparing Rakesh and tree. So I have used the comparative degree taller. Okay. Then grandfather was older than some of the oak trees. But Rakesh had grown too. He could run and jump and climb trees as well as most boys. Now Rakesh could climb, jump and he can enjoy the cherry tree as the other boys could. And he read a lot of books, although he still liked listening to grandfather's stories. Though he read his own storybooks, but still he enjoyed listening to the stories which his grandfather used to narrate to him. In the cherry tree, bees came to feed on the nectar in the blossoms. Now what is nectar? In the science you must have studied. A sugary fluid which is secreted by the flower. And from the flower the sugary fluid which is secreted, that is known as the nectar, and to collect that the bees used to come to the cherry tree and tiny birds pecked at the blossoms and broke them off. But the tree kept blossoming right through the spring, and there were always more blossoms than birds. So small birds used to come and they used to break these small flowers and all, the cherry flowers and all, but still every time there were more blossoms as compared to the birds. The summer there were small cherries on the tree. Rakesh tasted one and spat it out. Spat it out matlab thook dena, spit it out. It was sour. He said, they will be better next year, said grandfather. So when he tasted one of the cherry, he said, it's not tasty, it is sour. But grandfather assured him that next year it will be sweet. But the bird liked them, especially the bigger birds such as bulbuls, scarlet, minivets, and they fitted in and out of the foliage feasting on the cherries. Though Rakesh did not like the cherry, but the birds used to like, the big birds used to enjoy them. They used to come and go and enjoy these cherries. Now, flitted means to flutter. Bird pankh mein pharate hai na, usko kehte hai flutter. And foliage means plants. On a warm sunny afternoon when even the bees looked sleepy, Rakesh was looking for grandfather without finding him any of his favorite place around the house. Then he looked out of the bedroom window and saw grandfather reclining on a cane chair under the cherry tree. One sunny afternoon, he was looking for his grandfather but could not find him anywhere. At last, he found him that he was reclining. Reclining matlab aram kursi. Hindi mein hum bole to aram kursi hoti hai, jisme the elderly people lie down, relax, and they take a small jhulta hai, that kursi shakes. So that kind of a chair. In that, grandfather was taking rest under the cherry tree. There is just the right amount of shade here, said grandfather. And I like looking at the leaf. There's pretty leaves, said Rakesh. And they are always ready to dance in their breeze. So Rakesh also commented, yes, the leaves are very pretty and they are always ready to dance when the wind blows. After grandfather had come indoors, Rakesh went into the garden and lay down on the grass beneath the tree. So after all the talk, grandfather went inside and Rakesh, he lied down under the tree and he started gazing at the tree. Gazing, I already told you, to look, to stare at something. The leaves at the great blue sky, and turning on his side, he could see the mountains striding away into the clouds. Striding away means ek direction ki taraf move karna. Jab badal move karta hai, to we say no, that it's moving towards with the wind. So that is known as. He was still lying beneath the tree when the evening shadows crept across the garden. Grandfather came back and sat down beside Rakesh, and they awaited in silence until it was dark. So after some time, the grandfather also joined him under the cherry tree, and they were there till it was dark. There are so many trees in the forest, said Rakesh. What's so special about this tree? Why do you like it so much? So now Rakesh had a question that there are so many trees in our garden, but why do you enjoy this particular tree? We planted it ourselves, said grandfather. That's why it is special. So now grandfather said, we planted it and it is special because humne is paude ko ugte hue dekha hai. We have seen this plant grow from a small seed. It has grown up, it has grown taller than us, and now it is bearing fruit. We are enjoying the fruit, we are enjoying the shelter. So it is special. We have seen each step. First the goat had eaten the branches, then that lady came and cut the tree. Out of so many struggles, this tree has grown and flourished, and today it is standing in front of us, giving us shade and tasty cherry. Just one small seed, said Rakesh, and he touched the smooth bark of the tree that had grown. He ran his hand along the trunk of the tree and put his finger to the tip of a leaf. I wonder, he whispered, is this what it feels to be God? So now he say, after touching the tree, the trunk of the tree, the branch of the tree, the Rakesh questions himself, is it to feel like a god? Because God has created us. When we do good things, when we flourish, when we help others, when we are successful in our life, our parents says, ki, see, I am happy, I am proud to be. The same way when we do something good, we are following the right path, God also feels proud. The same feeling today grandfather and Rakesh was having when they are seeing this tree, when they know after so many struggles, this tree has grown up taller. Now it is bearing tasty cherries, giving shelter to the birds, giving shelter and shade to grandfather. So they are feeling proud. So he is questioning, this might be the same feeling which God feels when God sees us. Hope you all have understood this chapter. We have completed the chapter and today I have uploaded the question answers also. So question answers, children, you have to write in the copy. In the previous doubt session, one of the child asked me, ma'am, word meanings we have to write. You have to write the word meanings in the copy along with the question answers. Okay, so thank you. Oh, hope you all are studying well for your exam. Thank you.